everybody, thank you so much for stopping by. Today we're going to be doing a review on an Eva NYC product, but before I begin, I do want to say a special thank you to my channel members for helping support this channel through difficult times. If you would like to join our little membership program with our little cute bunny emotes, then I will have the link down below. So today we're reviewing the Just Glisten Hair and Body Shine Mist from Eva NYC. So the claim for this product is it's weightless, it adds shine and enhances curls, it's powered by aloe leaf, cactus flower, it has no sulfates, no parabens, it's certified vegan and cruelty free, and you get 4.3 fluid ounces of product. This is also the new aluminum packaging, so it is recyclable. I did get this set for free, but no obligation to make a video or anything. I'm sharing my honest thoughts. We're gonna break it down, pros and cons, and I'll definitely do a follow-up video on how I feel about this product once it's completely run out. It smells very good. It has like a very light floral scent. It's really hard to pinpoint what it is exactly because it only says fragrance in the ingredient list. I feel like it might be like the cactus flower or something, or aloe. I'm not sure. So you just shake it and you apply it to pre-styled hair as well as your skin. So in terms of skin, it really just leaves like a nice shine without any type of glitter. When I first heard about this product, I thought it was gonna be similar to like those glitter sprays you get during Halloween from like Walgreens or CVS, and you just spray it on your hair and it leaves like glitter particles. Like, that's really what I thought this was gonna be like, and it's really not. It's a very natural shine. It's like a glow, and on your hair it's more like a gloss. Like, it's just like a nice finishing spray is what it feels like. It doesn't leave your hair crunchy or sticky or anything like that. Same thing with your skin. It's very soft. It sinks into the skin and then you don't feel it anymore. So let's start with the hair. You just shake it and then you spray it. You can add a couple hair tosses in that. I've tried it a couple times. So far, so good. I like that it helps kind of cut down frizz. Right now, my hair is a little bit, it's not 100% dry, so there's not a lot of flyaways. But once it starts drying, you know, curly hair has a mind of its own. So I tend to have little hairs popping up, and that's when I use this. It's really great on the go. It's a small size, so I can picture myself, especially during the spring and summer months, just being outside and just spraying this all over. In terms of the skin, again, it's just a shine. It's no glitter. Nothing like that, which is a good thing because glitter tends to be bad for the environment. So I just sprayed it on my skin, and as you can see, it's just a shine. It's very simple, nothing crazy. I prefer to use it honestly on my hair instead of my skin, just because I feel like I see better results on my hair. On my skin, I don't necessarily need like a glistening spray, even though, again, it's cute. It's a little extra. Like, if you're doing like photography or something, or like you're on a date or you want cute pictures taken of yourself for Instagram, then I would definitely see where this would come in handy. For me, it's just something that I would use on my hair because, like I said, my hair could always use some type of product midway throughout the day when I'm already like been out for a while and the sun is kind of making my hair get a little frizzy. In terms of cons, it's not really a con, but it comes down to personal preference, whether you feel like this is a product that's worth spending. I'll have the price here. The prices do vary sometimes. I do like that Eva NYC tends to be a little bit more affordable. I mean, it's a little bit more than like herbal essences at the drugstore, but it's definitely less than like salon branded stuff that generally has the same ingredients. I feel like 9 times out of 10, I'm not gonna lie, anytime I look at salon brands, they always have sulfates and they always have silicones and they always have X, Y, and Z, things that they kind of talked out upon when it comes to drugstore. I don't want to get into a rant about that, but so far I like it. The packaging's cute, it smells good, it's decently priced, and it does the job for my hair. See like those little flyaways? That's what I would like spray down. The best part is that it's not heavy, so you can apply as much as you want, and you know that I tend to apply way too much of any type of product, but it doesn't end up sticky or crunchy or anything like that, which is honestly the best part for me because I am heavy-handed with literally everything that I have, and it bothers me too. So those are my overall thoughts. Let me know what you think down below. Would you give this a try, or do you think it's not really worth it? And I will see you next time right here with another video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and until next time, bye.